All right, and we are here for round number one. We have lost the die roll, and we're looking at a hand that has a turn two hangerback, a turn three level plus Sylvan Advocate, etc. So this is definitely a keeper. So go ahead and keep this. But we are on the draw, which is unfortunate. So Lumbering Falls looks like probably Bant Company. Drew another Secure the Wastes, and there's no reason to reveal for this Fortified because we're not casting anything. And these Secure the Wastes are... we'll see how good they are this game. Stratus Dancer, interesting. Well, Stratus Dancer is good because it has flying. Alright, so now that I drew Nissa, it changes my line of play. Normally I'd play Hangerback for one, then I would level it up and play Sylvan Advocate on three, but since I have Nissa, what I'd actually prefer to do is play Sylvan Advocate, then Nissa, then Hangerback for two. So, we're going to go with that, and then we'll go ahead and reveal, and play Sylvan Advocate, and go from here, and we're going to be taking it from this thing. Okay, this is a different deck than what I thought. Okay, so we're playing a Sultai colored deck, so no real idea what we're dealing with here. I don't really want to attack, because I feel like this could be a company deck that has Bounding Crisis, so yeah, I don't want to attack. If I had a Dromoka's Command, I would attack, but I don't want to risk it. And you know what? I don't care that I'm losing out on 2 points of damage, because that's not really how this deck wins. It kind of wins by just getting big, so I don't want to throw away an Advocate to a Bounding Crisis. And boom, there it is. So we played correctly by not running our creature into Bounding Crisis. Ooh, tapping the plant. So we're going to lose our Nissa here, probably. I can throw away Sylvan Advocate to keep a Nissa on one, but it's just not going to be worth it. So Nissa's down, unfortunately. No play, so probably a Collected Company, so again, I don't really want to attack into this. Now, I could play this Oath or something else, but I think I'm just going to play Hanger for 2 here, and then next turn I can play Oath or Secure or whatever. Alright, here comes Collected Company, which... doing it in response to the Hangerback is interesting. I don't know if there's actually a reason for that, or if it's just that's what's happening. Sky Spawner and Bounding Crisis, okay. Alright, so we're losing our Sylvan Advocate here. But I'm actually gonna block with Hangerback against one of these Crisises if they attack, because that's gonna give me two tokens capable of trading with these two flyers, which seems good to me. But our opponent is just sending upstairs. Not interested in giving us tokens. Alright, passing the turn again. Which is interesting. Let's see here. Now I'd rather play this Oath and try to find an Avacyn would be great. But we did not find Avacyn. We found a land, which we don't need, or a Lamholt Pacifist, which is pretty bad. What do we take here? I guess I take the Pacifist. And now, I guess we'll just play the Pacifist, play a Hangerback for one, and then ship the turn back. So now, actually playing this Hanger for one might have been a mistake. Another company, yeah. This might have been a mistake to play this for one. I should have probably actually saved it for Avacyn. So, I think I messed up there. And another Sky Spawner. We're just getting beat down by these flyers. And a Stratus Dancer. That's pretty bad. Alright, so I really need to draw a Dromoka's Command. Pretty bad, actually. Or an Avacyn. I'm just losing to a bunch of 2-1 flyers. Yeah, I should have actually, I should have not played this hangar back, because now Avacyn doesn't even save me. Dromoka's Command, that is good. Huh. Let's see, we don't have a land, so I can't start bashing with Sylvan Advocate. Could have started attacking with the Lamholt Butcher, if I wanted to. Just trades with a Bounding Crisis though, so I don't really want to make that attack. I think I just say go here. Just a third collected company. I'll be very unhappy if it is. Jeez. Wow, another 2-1. Two more 2-1 flyers? You gotta be kidding me! Oh my gosh. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, I think I'm just dead. I mean, we'll see what happens here, but I'm pretty sure even with this Dromoka's Command, I'm dead. A morph. It's probably yet another flyer. Just another one of these stupid Stratus Dancers. So I'd have to fire this off now if I want to. Alright, so I do have, there's one way I cannot lose, which is really awkward line, but alright, so we'll level up this hangar back here to 3. And then we cast Dromoka's Command. We have to put a counter on our opponent's creature. And then we have to fight it with our 3-3. So that kills one of the flyers and gives us a 3-3 flyer ourselves. Or 3-1-1 flyers. So now we have enough flyers to block all theirs. I mean, we're actually just dead if everything comes in, but we'll see what happens. And all right, we're dead. Yeah, we're dead here because we can only block. We can block 4 ground creatures, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we take one from a Scion. Actually, we're maybe not dead here. Maybe we're not dead. Yeah, we're actually, we can actually survive at 1 life. Okay. Yeah, we would actually be able to survive the attack. Alright, let's declare blocks. Block, block, block. Alright, we're down to 2. So now I have to draw another Dromoka's Command, and this has to not be another Stratus Dancer, basically, I think. Hang her back. Alright. Well, let's concede and see what it is. It was another Stratos Dancer. Alright, so Clip Wings seems good. Sigarda seems good, just having a stupid flyer. Linval also seems good. Just big flyers seem good. Probably want Clip Wings. Promise to sacrifice creatures with flying. I'm gonna cut these pacifists. I don't think they're good in this matchup. I don't know about Secure the Waste. Doesn't seem good in this matchup either. So many flying creatures. Let's see. What do we have for enchantments? I think we're fine. I think we can actually bring in Tragic. A couple Tragic Arrogances. Arrogance is gonna be good against all those flyers. We can leave them with like an Eldrazi Scion or something with Sky Spawner. So let's try maybe two of these. Actually, let's try Evolutionary Leap. Leap is pretty good against these decks. Maybe I do want Tragic Arrogance, but we're gonna try without it and try to rely on these flying creatures to stop the air attack. Okay. Alright, we'll try this and see how this goes. I did not expect to lose to Collected Company 3x times into nothing but 2-1 flyers. My kingdom for a Minister of Pain. Alright, so we'll play first. This hand is good. We'll keep it. We have Evolutionary Leap plus Hangar Back's a good combination. Nissa and Gideon. We just have a pretty good hand here. Draw a Westvale Abbey. Now an important thing to note is next turn I'm probably going to play this Abbey instead of this Plains in case I draw Fortified Village. Well, now I'm just going to play the Fortified Village, but my point remains. Okay, two islands. I don't feel too scared about two islands. I think I can attack into that. Maybe there might be Rattle Chains. It would not surprise me. We've seen so many 2-1 flyers already that our opponent may just simply be playing every 2-1 flyer in the format. Alright, Fortified Village revealing this. Nessa might get negated. Nope. Alright, let's put a plant in and then let's see if that Rattle Chains prediction is correct. Oh man, I'm on top of the game right now. Oh man, I think it's hilarious that this deck is just as many 2-1 flyers as is feasibly possible. It's funny. Alright, Oath of Nissa. So, because we're going to lose Gideon's loyalty, I think that I want to just make an emblem with Gideon. And that's going to make Evolutionary Leap with this Hangerback Walker a lot better too. It's just going to make everything better. These plants are better. Just everything. So unless our opponent has another Rattle Chains, our Nissa is pretty safe to make another 1-2 plant, which is actually a relevant body, you know, in light of what our opponent has done thus far. Westvale Abbey, interesting. So we're probably going to get companied. This looks like a definite Collected Company to me. Ooh, Sigarda. Huh. Yeah, I think I just jam the Sigarda here. I And then hopefully our opponent doesn't company into something that punishes us for this. We could get like clip wings did or something, but whatever. Alright, here's the company. Oh, it could be. Yep, figured it out. Stupid. I should have thought about Silumgar Sorcerer. Well, at least it was just the Sorcerer. We also do get to attack here too, which is actually kind of nice. So there was some merit in playing it pre-combat. Get to hit our opponent for 4. We do lose our dearly beloved Nissa. Is it another collected company? Yep. Kromoka's Command, that's a good one. Huh, alright, well, Oath of Nissa. Start with Oath of Nissa, see what we find off of this. That's a good one to find. Archangel Avacyn. Alright, and we'll go to combat, see if anything gets played. Nothing gets played. Alright, I don't want to attack, I don't think, into the company. I just want to cast this Evolutionary Leap. And now I can actually level Hangerback and sack to Leap if I need to, which is good against any number of 2-1 flyers. Oh, there's another one, and a bounty increases. I can also fight Hangerback against bounty increases, but I think I'd rather just level it. Ooh, our opponent was gracious enough to untap our Hangerback Walker. That's something you only see on Magic Online, but. You know, a little bit. I think it's funny either way. Okay, so we end up winning that game thanks to the Hangerback Evo Leap connection. Our opponent does have Westvale Abbey though, so that is something to think about. Clipwings and Stasis Snare are hopefully enough to take care of Abbey. Could maybe bring in Declaration. Declaration's certainly a possible way to take care of that card, because right now we only have a couple of answers to Westvale Abbey. What would I side out? I don't really want to cut any of these. I think we're just going to run it back, and hopefully we don't get specifically Abbeyed, but that's the plan. Okay. I'm going to actually keep this hand, even though it doesn't look particularly great. We do have Hangerback on 2, Advocate on 3, and if we draw a white source, our hand's like actually very, very good. Well, ask and ye shall receive. Hangerback plus Dromoka's Command's quite good against this deck, because Thopters are just very good against an exorbitant amount of 2-1 flyers. I wonder if our opponent also is playing the Eldrazi Flyer too. That'd be sweet. Hangerback Walker. Still good. Alright. Opponent is deep in the tank. Just playing a Stratus Dancer. Okay. Linvala. Don't mind if I do. Linvala is going to be a good one, hopefully, at some point. Panoramic's a lot better against a deck that doesn't have Reflector Mage, that's for sure. Ooh, no play. I like that. Here I could play the Oath, but I'd rather just have the mana to level the Hanger. So there's Rattle Chains. We'll go ahead and level up our Hangerback Walker in response in case it dies somehow. So now, if our opponent's representing the potential... Oh, Harbinger. Oh, gross. That is disgusting. That is not a card I expected. I could have played around that. But, yeah. Just was not on my radar at all. That's unfortunate. That may be pretty devastating for us. Alright, well, I need to play this Oath to find a land here. We did find a land. Canopy Vista. Okay, now I can actually sit on Avacyn plus Hanger if I want to. And I can sit up on like Stasis Nerd, Remoka's Command, etc. Yeah, and I think I'm actually, well, I kind of want to just fire this off now. That may be a mistake because my plan is to Archangel Hangerback, but I feel like if I get Archangel Hangerback going, especially with Linvala and so forth, that I'm going to win, that I would rather not take the extra damage in the meantime. We're definitely taking some damage here. Taking 4 damage down to 10. Plus also having a counter on this means it survives Archangel Hangerback, which we can't do yet. Looks like I have to just play a Gideon. Luckily, I've had other plays that are reasonable to make so that our opponent isn't, you know, we're not telegraphing Archangel Hangerback, which is nice. Although now we're at risk of Silumgar Sorcerer, which is unfortunate. Hopefully our opponent just plays something here. Another Bounding Crisis. Good. I like it. I like it a lot. That is going to make Archangel Hangerback a more potent line of play. Alright, let's see what the attack is. This at Gideon, this at Gideon. All of them at Gideon. Alright, well, I can't save Gideon, but I can eat this. Gideon served as a fog, though, which is pretty great. We also could just play Linvala here. Is that better? I just gain 5 life. I think that's actually just better. I gain 5 life and make a 3/3 flyer, and then now I just have this giant board. And I can still do this Archangel Hangerback play next turn if I need to. But our opponent's just extremely low on life, and we're just actually now the aggressor, so seems to work out pretty well. Okay, and I feel like there's a Collected Company in our future. Ooh, another Avacyn. This is actually pretty sweet. I get to attack with everything here. When our opponent can cast a... Ooh, doesn't even have Collected Company. That's nice. Okay. Okay, and that's a concession. Excuse me. So, if our opponent blocks, then we can just flash in Avacyn, give all our creatures indestructible, then play the Hangarback for 0 second main phase, wrath our opponent's board. So, definitely a cool interaction that we would have had access to there, but our opponent conceded, so we ended up winning instead. We are now 1-0, and hopefully you'll stay tuned for the other matches.